playoffs like that with COVID and injuries, to your point, it's hard to continue winning. But the one thing they do have, they have the Joker. And think about this. You can run your offense through him because of this reason. If you put a smaller guy on him, he takes him down in the post and abuses him and then forces you to double team, and he passes the ball and get wide open shots and hits cutters. If the big doesn't come out, he knocks down threes. And if you come at him aggressive, he will show and go. And I mean, big fella will put it on the floor and then draw the defense and make passes. He is the most complete center I've seen in NBA. I can't even, you can't compare him at the center position. Maybe Bill Walton, a little small version of Bill Walton. But when you watch his passing, his quickness, and that right there what separates him. His ability to take advantage of people on the post and use his body. It's not about athleticism. It's about using that body. Channing, this is what's scary. He'll be able to play till he's 40, 42, 43. Why? He's like Sam Cassell. It's not about athleticism. His basketball IQ and his skill is off the chart.
Yeah. I talked about it now.
I'm writing that down. Most complete center that you ever seen.
That I've seen. I can't. I'm just thinking off the top of my mind. When you talk about passing, shooting, dribbling, I can't think of a center just right off the top of my mind.
Offensively.
That can do the things that he can do.
Defensively, he's not a slouch.
No. Nope.
So, especially this year, it seems they've made a concerted effort. Now, I don't know if that's different schemes or Aaron Gordon, but without the injury. So, he's better defensively. He's as a center, he doesn't have a hole in his game.
Well, break it down for us then. Let's do it.
Because, obviously, Mitchell Robinson's in a drop of ice, and we know that Aaron Gordon is the roller. And it hits an absolute dime. It makes it rain. Now, look, he's just jogging up the court, just gets to the right spot, nothing fast, and then takes advantage and dunks it, right? And has more dunks than what you would think. Again, slow rolling, using his body, takes his time, sets another screen. Mitchell Robinson is in his regular coverage, dropping ice. Mitchell Robinson is slow because he knows, even though he's not fast, he's quick and can get by you. And again, here, he just curls. Mitchell Robinson thinks he's going in for a layup, takes his sweet time, and hits another three. So how do you guard him? Right. And my biggest thing with him is defensively, you want to get him in a rush. You can't. It's almost impossible to get him in a rush because he's like, well, if you're going to double team me here, I'll just move to the free throw line. Oh, then I'll move to the 3-point line or I'll go to that side of court. We don't talk about him enough as MVP candidate, but he should be in the MVP candidacy because this Denver Nuggets team should not be 11-11.
No.
And they are because of him, so give him his credit.
He takes advantage of every mistake that you make.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever opportunity you give him, he sees it. He don't make bad plays. He don't turn the ball over. He don't take bad shots. He is just, man, the consummate pro. And look, you said it. The reason Denver right now hanging around is because of this man right here. And if they can get Jamal Murray back and get some of these other guys healthy, they can make a late push all because of him.
And you see on and off the court, we know that he missed time with that wrist injury. They didn't win when he wasn't there. Obviously, they've already been decimated by so many injuries. But you see by the numbers right there how much better he makes that Denver Nuggets team, to your point.
So certain guys need a high usage rate, right? But they're dribbling the ball. You can run any type of offense you want through him. You want to run dribble handoffs. You want to run post action like they used to run the triangle in Chicago, in L.A. You want to run like a four out, right? Four out, one in. You want to run a screen and roll, have him roll to the hoop or pop. You can run all those things based on who else is out there. If you see him, everyone is flying and cutting, and he's not out there looking for himself. You have to have a concerted game plan to make him score. Right? It's not like he's out there looking for a shot. Yeah. He's like, well, you're too slow. Okay, I'll take this because you gave it to me.
Yeah.
The only other player I've seen like that, or when people treat them like that, is Steve Nash. And he's a center. So that's a huge compliment to me, or to him, that he can play that type of game.